Hi, my name is Crispy. I'm a developer advocate on the Google Cast team. In this episode of DevBytes, I'm going to cover some of the essentials of creating a Cast Web Sender app that runs in Chrome. Currently, the Google Cast SDK is available for three platforms: Chrome, Android, and iOS. In this video, I will focus exclusively on the SDK for Chrome. In order to build a Google Cast Web Sender application, you will need to install the Google Chrome browser and the Google Cast Chrome extension. If you already have Chrome installed, make sure you are on version 32 or higher. To get the Cast extension, visit the Google Chrome Web Store and search for Google Cast. The Cast extension is what allows web senders to communicate with Cast receivers. With Chrome installed and the Cast extension ready to go, let's take a peek at the Cast Sender lifecycle for a moment. Once a Cast Sender application has been loaded, the app will detect and initialize the Cast APIs, get notified about available receivers, connect to a receiver, and begin exchanging messages over the established connection. Closing out the lifecycle is disconnection from a receiver device. Let's take a closer look at each phase of the lifecycle. Chrome Sender applications are constructed using HTML, JavaScript, and CSS. Sender apps can be hosted locally during development and then moved to production servers when publishing. A Google-hosted Cast Sender JavaScript resource provides the API that your Sender application uses to communicate with the Cast extension, which manages the interaction with Cast receivers. A Chrome Sender application must detect and initialize the Cast API before communicating with the Cast receiver. Prior to using the Cast APIs, the Web Sender application needs to first check that they are available. This is accomplished by looking for the existence of chrome.cast JavaScript namespace and checking the chrome.cast.isavailable boolean flag. Depending on how the Web Sender application loads its resources, it may need to set up a retry timeout to detect the Cast APIs. With the detection out of the way, the Web Sender application is now ready to initialize the Cast API. Initialization connects the Web Sender to the Cast extension and lets the extension know that the web app is Cast enabled. Performing the initialization consists of creating a sender request object that holds the application ID of the receiver that will launch. Then, constructing a new API config object, which takes the session request object as well as a session listener and receiver listener callbacks. Lastly, the web sender calls the chrome.cast.initialize function and provides the API config object along with a success and error callback. When the success callback is invoked, the web application has successfully initialized the Cast APIs. However, there is one more thing that the application needs to wait on before proceeding. Looking at the API config constructor, the receiver listener passed in performs an important role in the discovery of Cast devices. Cast Web Sender applications delegate the management of available Cast receiver devices to the Cast extension. The API config that the app creates is passed along to the Cast extension, and the receiver listener is invoked. The receiver listener is passed a string parameter that should be checked for the available value. Any other value should be treated as no receiver devices available. The receiver listener will be invoked whenever there is a change in the availability of receiver devices. The web sender should display the Cast icon when the receiver listener reports Cast receivers are available. Now that the application knows when to show a Cast icon to the user, we can explore how to request a session on a Cast receiver device. It's actually quite simple. The sender can call on chrome.cast.requestSession and provide a success and error callback. The success callback will be passed a Cast Session object that can be decorated with update listeners. The session success callback is dependent on user action and may not be invoked. Let's take a look. Use the receiver listener as a way to determine if the web sender application should show the Cast icon to the user. When the user clicks the Cast icon, the Cast extension will show a list of available Cast receiver devices that can be connected to by the sender. If the user closes the list without selecting a device, the request session error callback will be invoked. Otherwise, if the user selects a Cast receiver device, then the extension will communicate with the Cast receiver to set up a communication channel. Once complete, the success callback of the request session function will be invoked. With a connection established, the sender application may now communicate with the connected Cast receiver application. Messages are exchanged between the sender and receiver using namespaces, also called protocols. These messages are used to invoke behaviors on the receiver application and to update the sender application as to the state of the receiver app. One example of message exchange would be to load some media onto the Cast receiver. The Cast APIs come bundled with a media API that enables a sender app to tell the receiver to load and play back media, such as video. In this case, the media info object gets created that bundles the information about the media. This object is then used to create a load request object that gets passed to a session function called load media. The load media function serializes the data and communicates with the receiver application over the media namespace. Sender and receiver applications must agree on the supported namespaces in order to communicate with each other. The last part of the lifecycle is the disconnection from a receiver. When a session is first established, the session app is passed a session object. Adding an update listener to the session object allows the sender app to know when a session has ended. The session listener function is passed a Boolean value. If this value is false, then there is no connection. The user can initiate a disconnect by clicking the Cast extension and choosing Stop Casting. This will trigger a session update listener when the session is torn down. And there you have it, the lifecycle of a Cast web sender. We're very excited to see what you build with Google Cast. To get you going, we are providing a number of resources. You can discover more about the details of the Google Cast SDK at developers.google.com/cast. The design checklist will go a long way in guiding you down the path to creating great second screen applications. You can find sample Cast sender and receiver apps at github.com/googlecast. Use Stack Overflow for questions and comments. Tag them with Google-Cast. In future DevBytes, we will dive deeper into the Cast sender SDK for each platform and the Cast receiver SDK. Join the Google Cast developer community on Google+ for pro tips and share your experiences. It's now up to you to go out and create great Chrome web sender applications. Happy casting.